Hello, wonderful people. I'm Stefanina Dalny from Wonderbot Animals. And here is...
You'll never guess the sea creature this young boy befriended.
Before we begin, make sure to click the like button, subscribe to our channel, and click the notification button for more amazing videos.
For Joel, a dog or cat just wasn't going to cut it. He had another animal in mind that he could call a pseudo-pet. Their daily routine had Joel going down to the water in his village to interact with the amazing creature, showing people that they are not to be feared. Jake Wilton, an underwater photographer from Australia, found the same thing while diving around a reef. The creature was gigantic, but far from harmful. It was placid, even, wanting nothing more than help from someone it trusted. Joel is a young boy who lives in Valle Gran Rey, a tiny village on La Gomera, one of Spain's Canary Islands. The town is known for its beautiful black sand beaches and top-notch dive sites. Tourists aren't the only ones that are attracted to the beauty of the island, though. The village is also known for its harbor, so one can typically see boats as well as fishermen lining the waters. Often, they throw unwanted fish back into the water, which then attracts even more sea creatures. That's how Joel met his unlikely friend. One morning, Joel and his friend went down to the harbor waters with food. And what seemed like a typical event for the boys turned into something else altogether for onlookers. Someone captured the two on film, hanging out on the steps that go into the harbor. Again, it seemed as though the young boys were just hanging out near the water. Then Joel started to splash the water around with his hands, almost as if he were trying to alert someone. After all of the splashing subsided, Joel noticed a huge fin swimming towards him. Anyone else would most likely be a bit frightened with a giant black fin coming out of the water and swimming straight for them, but Joel was cool as a cucumber, as if he'd done this a thousand times. And that fistful of food he carried down to the water? Apparently that wasn't for him at all. Rather than eat it, he tossed the food scraps into the water. The second the food hit the surface, the water began to move rapidly. Joel is in the harbor, so wakes are few and far between. This creature had some power. After all of the food was devoured, the water stopped moving. But the videographers weren't finished seeing something unbelievable. When they thought the mystery creature left, the water started to move again. This time, the creature came back at the young boy more forcefully. By this point, the people watching from the sidelines finally figured out what the mystery animal was. A gigantic manta ray had been approaching the young boy, not at all afraid that the creature was out of water. But there was no aggression between the wild sea creature and Joel. It's almost as though the manta ray expected Joel to be there to feed him his lunch. Some of the local fishermen knew about the encounter and supplied Joel with shrimp to feed his friend. Unlike most manta rays, Joel's buddy has made it perfectly clear that he would rather be hand-fed than hunt for his meals. The best part is, he gets some pats after eating. In the video, Joel is seen helping the manta ray put his front fin above the lowest step, a better angle for Joel to give the creature a nice rub down after his meal. He even raises his fin in appreciation after the meal, a nice back rub. The sea creature likes to interact with the young boy. It does not seem afraid at his touch or the food he is feeding him. It's quite amazing. The giant manta ray almost has a puppy-like quality about him, especially considering he goes in for pats and treats. Not once did the creature do anything remotely aggressive or threatening. We bet that won't be the last time the manta ray will journey to the harbor, though. It is most likely a routine, and he'll be back the next day, and the day after to see his human friend. Although Joel's manta ray buddy is very friendly, many superstitions surround the sea creature, one of which is an old sailor myth. It's said that the manta rays are bad luck because they will bring death to the entire crew. This is because it was believed that manta rays were able to attach themselves to the anchor of a ship, dragging the entire ship down to Davy Jones' locker. Can you believe that they were feared just as much, if not more, than sharks? Over the years, the superstitions became mere whispers. Even so, maritime workers will still call manta rays sea devils or devilfish, just for old time's sake. Even so, these creatures have become a sort of tourist attraction. Divers will follow the species in hopes of swimming alongside them. This is an activity that was once thought of as a huge risk. Now, people realize that the sea creatures are actually very playful, and not nearly as aggressive as they thought. Underwater photographer and diver Jake Wilton can personally attest to how friendly these gentle giants are. In 2019, a manta ray, nicknamed Freckles by the locals, was found swimming around Ningaloo Reef in Australia with several fish hooks wedged under her right eye. It must have been painful. And with no way to remove the hooks by herself, the manta ray thought it was best to ask for a helping hand. Underwater photographer Jake Wilton was out diving one day with marine biologist Monty Hall when Freckles swam right up to him. "I'm often guiding snorkelers in the area, and it's as if she recognized me and she was trusting me to help her," he says. "She got closer and closer and then started unfurling to present the eye to me. I knew we had to get the hooks out of her eye or she would have been in big trouble. Wilson had to move fast and carefully so he did not further injure the poor creature." Thankfully, Wilton understood what Freckles was trying to tell him. She needed help removing the hooks, and she was recruiting him to do it. Unfortunately, Wilton was a photographer and not a surgeon, so he didn't really know what he was doing. All he knew was that he had to work diligently and move slowly so that he didn't scare off Freckles. She was going to be in big trouble if those hooks stayed that close to her eye. Hall filmed the entire encounter, getting the incredible moment on film. It must have been wondrous for him, as a scientist, to witness such an interaction between man and a huge sea creature, especially one that was staying still and had complete trust in the human trying to help. "I'm sure that manta knew that Jake was trying to get the hooks out," says Hall. Wilton says, "She knew exactly what was going on. She had to show me, give me access. It's incredible for an animal to work that out so quickly. And he worked just as quickly, removing the hooks one at a time, so he didn't hurt the creature." During the entire procedure, Freckles never moved. She was the perfect patient, allowing Wilton to help her without freaking out in the process. It doesn't hurt that manta rays are known to be highly intelligent creatures, so she probably knew he meant her no harm.